where everything will be on the line for the ultimate gold in Nice. Today in Japan, the four corners of the globe are represented as well-known stars look to further impress the international judges, and rising stars hope to add their names to the guest list. From North America, Asia, Africa, and Australia, they're here for the Four Continents Figure Skating Championships, next on ABC Sports. Osaka, Japan, a tale of two cities here in what was once the Japanese capital. From its ancient temples dating back centuries to the urban maze that has become today, you'll need more than a map to find your way around this country's second largest city. Population of over 2.5 million people here. And we welcome you inside the Osaka Pool and Ice Arena, where 99 skaters from 12 different nations are here for the Four Continents Figure Skating Championships. And hi, everybody. I'm Terry Gannon. This is the last major event prior to the upcoming World Championships. And for some of the skaters here, a stretch run scramble to try to make their country's World Championship team. For others, whose bags are already packed for Nice, a perfect opportunity to gain momentum, exposure, and keep their edge. With that in mind, we welcome in two-time Olympic champion, Mr. Dick Button. Dick, a relatively new event, only in its second year. There are skaters from all across the world, except for Europe here. How did this event come about?
Well, you know, this championship is really a geographic equalizer. The European skaters have always had the European championships to strut their stuff in front of international judges before the World Championships, while skaters from North America, Africa, Asia, and Australia didn't. Well, now they do. So what does it mean for North American skaters in particular? It opens up new international experience at the top level for dancers like Lang and Chernyshev. For pair skaters Ina and Zimmerman, it provides the chance to further meld their styles in front of international judges, which is really where it counts. And for Todd Eldridge, well, it gives him the chance to step back into the amateur competitive scene before he begins another Olympic run. You know, it's kind of nice to see this competitive world on an equal footing at last.
Mm-hmm. Well, the men, the pairs, and the ice dancers on tap today. But first on the ice, it will be the ladies. And we welcome in Olympic champion Peggy Fleming. Peggy, so far after the short program, a very strong showing for American skaters.
Well, we certainly have, Terry. We have two American girls in the position to win the gold medal here in Osaka. Angela Nikodinov, who has a history of missed opportunities, is in second place after the short program and has another golden opportunity to prove herself. She needs to channel all her natural ability into this free skate, or she runs the risk of being passed by once again. Because right behind her is another of the new young talents emerging on the American scene, Stacy Penjin. This is her first senior international event, and if she could win this title here, it would be an enormous stamp of approval for Stacy, and that would strengthen her place in the sea of talent back home.
So heading into the free skate, the standings right now, a surprise leader, Annie Belmar of Canada, the only one to skate cleanly in the short program. She's in the lead, but right behind her, the two Americans, Angela Nikodinov and then Stacy Penjin.
America. On the ice, representing the USA, Angela Nikodinov.
And it's Angela Nikodinov who will get us underway here in the free skate. The 19-year-old from San Pedro, California, who finished fourth at the recent U.S. Championships, named as an alternate to the World Championship team.
She's skating to the music from the motion picture, The Mummy.
She has always been an extraordinarily competent and completely brilliant jumper. This is her opening move, a triple lutz. Combination, beautifully done.
Now a triple loop. It's back outside edge takeoff. Very solid.
Mm-hmm.
Angela finished third in this event last season. She made it to Worlds a year ago, where she placed 12th. Now she has to wait and see if Sasha Cohen, the 15-year-old, can medal at the Junior Worlds. Does not meet the age requirements without doing that.
Beautiful layback.
Triple flip, double toe.
If you look very carefully at that, you'll see a toe pick. It always looks to me as though it's not set quite strongly into the ice, yet the jumps are terrific.
Yeah, she has a lot of power in her jump. She could get a lot more lift if that was a better takeoff.
Salchow, double Salchow.
Moves like this could be stretched more. More extension. And then this would have more power in her number if she really stretched some of these moves out.
Triple Lutz jump right here. Yeah. Now that was the toe pick again. I think it wasn't quite straight, and when it isn't, it's like that the end of the pole vault. If it twists in the slightest way, it's going to throw you off the line of the jump.
And now her final triple, this triple toe. Very nice. And double toe after.
That program, you know, the end of it just sort of drizzled right off. It doesn't sustain your interest. The program, during the program, she started out with wonderful strength and security and then opened up on one combination and missed on another flip. It was just, it's what's happened to her. She hasn't been able to keep the whole thing at a high level of intensity. Now, look at this opening triple Lutz jump that she does. She really steps right here, swinging into it. Doesn't look like it's a secure toe pick, but it's a beautiful jump combination. Really first rate. She's a marvelous athlete. And in this triple Lutz, watch again what she does here. Now watch the toe pick right there. You see it sort of flattens out. It flips her up into the air into a single jump. It's almost as though she hasn't maintained concentration.
And not to offer any excuses at all, but she still is dealing with a sprained ankle, which she suffered before the U.S. Championship, so she says she is not 100%. Two sets of marks, of course, the first for technical merit, 5.2 up to 5.7 the range.
Well, essentially those marks are in the 5.3 to 5.5 range, and that's not good enough for Angela. Mm-hmm. She is a brilliant athlete, and I think she will be able to do even better than that if she gets her whole act together.
And now the marks for presentation, and those are similar. So Angela Nikodinov in the lead for the moment. She'll have to wait to see what happens with the rest of the ladies. When we return, Annie Bellemare of Canada, the surprise leader after the short program. She skates next. Taking the ice is the surprise leader after the short program, Annie Bellemare of Canada, who finished 12th at this event last season, now has the lead. The 20-year-old from Quebec. Can she keep it together over the next 4 minutes?
Well, this is the first time she's been in the pressure position at an international event. That can either scare you or lift your performance. Her opening jump is a triple salchow. Bring it back, inside edge takeoff. Very nice.
Well, she sailed into that, didn't she?
She has a nice, fresh, bouncy quality about her skating. And now the triple lutz, double toe.
Marvelous height. Marvelous height.
The bronze medalist from the Canadian National Championship this season. Canada only sending one lady to the World Championships. That will be Jennifer Robinson, who won.
Double instead of a triple.
This layback spin, not a great position.
Hey, Peggy, congratulations.
Oh, yeah.
Long last.
That was so obvious.
I know. I hate being the only one that says the position is not good.
You got some company, Dick.
Oh, makes me feel very no longer lonely. She does get good height and spring on her jumps. She has wonderful, you know, height on that triple lutz at the beginning.
Well, she looks like she's attacking this program a lot more than I have seen, even at her national Canadian championship. Good energy at this point in this program.
She's maintaining her speed. Triple lutz again.
Double toe. Final jump, this triple toe, double toe combination. That's unfortunate to end a program like this.
You know, she had some moments going there, a lot of good positive qualities, and I think that would have stood her in fairly good stead, particularly considering her first position. The fall at the end didn't help at all.
Never won a gold medal at an event like this on the international scene. Annie Belmar will have remarks when we come back to Osaka. And then the 17-year-old from Fairport, New York, Stacy Penjin, will take the ice looking for her most impressive finish as a senior skater. That's next. Back to the Four Continents Championships here in Osaka. Annie Belmar of Canada was the leader after the short program. Now her marks, technical merit in the 5.0 to 5.4 range.
5.4, 5.3,
20-year-old.
5.4.
Won a silver medal last year at Canadian Nationals, a bronze medal this season. Presentation marks 5.1 to 5.5. So Annie Belmar drops to second behind Angela Nikodinov of the U.S., who now has the lead.
And she should be very happy with that.
Stacey Pangin.
And here is Stacey Pangin, the 17-year-old from Fairport, New York. What a way to go into your first senior international competition, at least into the free skate, in third place with a chance to win the gold medal.
And if you look closely, she looks a lot like a young Peggy Fleming.
Mm. Well, thank you. I take that as a compliment.
It was intended to be.
Are there any Dick Buttons out there skating today?
Not today.
They're coming later, Terry. She's opening with a triple lutz, double toe.
Oh, good, good.
I couldn't have done that better myself. Now another combination, a triple flip. Double toe.
Wow. Did you see that switch again in the air?
Yes.
From where we were sitting, you could see a straight line curving in and then out again. Thank heaven she landed that. Double axel. Single.
Triple sow cow.
Oh, whoa. She slipped off that back inside edge, and of course it doubled it.
Angela Nikodinov in the lead right now, and Stacy trains right alongside Angela in Detroit. They're both coached by Richard Callahan.
Toe loop combination. Double toe loop. Combination spin. First camel spin. Catch foot position. Nice catch. Lay back. Could have been better. The back could be stretched a little here. But a nice combination overall. But lands it like with beautiful ease.
I'm surprised she gets so much lift. She doesn't reach back for that takeoff very much, but she's very effective. She has nice flow over the ice. I wish she would use moves like that slide spiral, to more of an advantage and use it to the beat of the music and hold it more.
It's like
much
she's
more effective.
It's like she's rushing through one move after the other without fully feeling it.
But that comes with time, with a better package, a better program, better choreography, better music. That package gets put together and it really shows you off to the best advantage.
But a very nice overall program for this young lady. She should be very proud of herself. It was a good presentation, a solid presentation, with all the elements steadily in place.
Will it be Stacey Pangin? Will it be Angela Nikodinov? It may come down to those two Americans for the gold medal here in Osaka.
And this was her opening triple Lutz double toe combination that was very solid. Went up in the air, very straight in the air, leaning over a little bit on the landing, up into the double toe. But it was a wonderful opening. And it kind of set the stage for her performance in the second triple combination, triple flip, double toe. Very nice.
So let's see. The technical merit marks for Stacy now. In the 5.3 to 5.5 range.
And those are very creditable marks. It was a very creditable performance all the way around. She's like a lanky young filly, you know, just waiting for her to pull those edges together in the position. And I think she'll be a major position in American skating.
And now the second set of marks for presentation, 5.1 up to 5.7, a wide range, but those are good enough to pull Stacy Pengin up to second place, and that's where she will finish. The final results, Angela Nikodina of the first gold medal at this level. Stacy Pengin, her first medal of any kind on the international level as a senior skater. They both join Susie Wynn right now.
Thanks, Terry. Now, Stacy, the first senior international and a medal. Wow, not bad.
Yeah, I'm so excited right now. I could just die.
Was it unexpected?
Yeah. I didn't know what to expect coming into this competition because I just remember last year when people came back from it, I was like, oh, four continents, it's a senior, ooh, they did well. And then, I don't know, I had no idea what to expect, so I'm just so happy.
Well, here you are. Now, Angela, it's been a year of ups and downs. This is perhaps the biggest victory of the season. Tell me about it.
It's my first big international that I've won, so I'm just really excited to be in this position right now. And I didn't even skate the best that I could for myself, but overall I'm really pleased with the way everything came out.
We're proud of you. Congratulations. Good luck. Terry, back to you.
All right, Susie, thank you. Quite an event for Angela Nikodinov. She has to wait to find out whether or not she will skate at the World Championships in Nice, but she knows she's the gold medalist here in Osaka. And Stacy Pengin, the 17-year-old, her first senior international competition, and she skates away with the silver medal. When we come back, the lady who won this event last season, Tatiana Malinina, needing a comeback here, though. She's in fifth place. She'll take the ice next. And on the ice now, Tatiana Malinina of Uzbekistan. She lives in Dale City, Virginia now, but she won this event last season, the 7-time national champion of Uzbekistan.
She's skating to the music Malagueña. She gives it a lot of flair and fire.
You notice the first five moves of her program are all of her triples, one right after the other, nothing in between. Here's the Lutz. Well, there was the Lutz. She has a very powerful kind of presence on the ice.
Well, she gives this number a lot of attitude.
Here's the second one, triple flip. Oh, look at the way she turned that edge. Move number three, the triple toe loop, double toe loop. Wow, this is not her best afternoon.
Well, and she's had injuries throughout the season, too. Suffered a groin injury that kept her off the ice for some time. Had a cyst removed from her heel, which was very painful. And she says she may be about 20%.
And that was just done in December, so she took a whole month off the ice.
But you see the way she went up into that, what was to have been a triple loop. She was off edge, off angle, outside of the circle. She's been kind of off-center on all of these jumps so far. Here's the final one, a triple salchow, double toe. A little bit of a double foot landing.
Nice positions. Good speed in this combination spin.
had a remarkable year last season. Won this event, won the Grand Prix final, finished just off the podium at Worlds. Hasn't been able to match that this year.
It was a very steady stroke on the ice. See if she's able to handle this a little better. Oh, she substituted a double toe loop for her triple Lutz. This is a layback, which is a very weak position. She has a nice presence on the ice, and I like this, the simplicity of her skating, with the exception of her hands, which I think are well overdone.
This is a nice section of footwork. Very much in the character of the music. Double axel.
Now look at the position in this flying camel. Very nice, good speed, good centering. That's a solid turn. The hands look a little bit like, almost like claws at the end of her arms. Mm-hmm. Overdone. They don't match the simplicity of the rest of her skating.
Nice scratch spin at the end. She gives it a lot of energy. This sure wasn't her night, though.
In fifth place after this short program, maybe tough to move up with that performance. Not going to like her marks, but we're going to come back to Osaka with them in a moment. We're back at the Four Continents Championships here in Osaka, Japan, and the marks for Tatiana Malinina, who was in fifth place after the short program. The first set, 4.3 up to 4.8.
Well, considering the fact that she hardly landed a single triple jump, those marks are pretty good.
And her marks for presentation. So Tatiana Malinina into second place behind Angela Nikodinov of the U.S. Taking the ice is the surprise leader after the short program, Annie Belmar of Canada, who finished 12th at this event last season, now has the lead. The 20-year-old from Quebec. Can she keep it together over the next 4 minutes?
Well, this is the first time she's been in the pressure position at an international event. That can either scare you or lift your performance. Her opening jump is a triple salchow. Right back inside edge takeoff. Very nice.
Oh, she sailed into that, didn't she?
She has a nice, fresh, bouncy quality about her skating. And now the triple Lutz, double toe.
Marvelous height. Marvelous height.
The bronze medalist from the Canadian National Championship this season. Canada only sending one lady to the World Championships. That will be Jennifer Robinson, who won.
Instead of a triple.
Triple loop. layback's been not a great position.
Hey, Peggy, congratulations.
Oh, yeah.
Long last.
That was so obvious.
I know. I hate being the only one that says the position is not good.
You got some company, Dick.
Oh, makes me feel very no longer lonely. She does get good height and spring on her jumps. She has wonderful, you know, height on that triple Lutz at the beginning.
Well, she looks like she's attacking this program a lot more than I have seen, even at her national Canadian championship. Good energy at this point in this program.
She's maintaining her speed. Triple Lutz again.
Double toe. Final jump, this triple toe, double toe combination. That's unfortunate to end a program like this.
You know, she had some moments going there, mm-hmm. A lot of good positive qualities, and I think that would have stood her in fairly good stead, with particularly considering her first position. The fall at the end didn't help at all.
Never won a gold medal at an event like this on the international scene. Annie Belmar will have remarks when we come back to Osaka. Welcome back to the Four Continents Championships here in Osaka. Annie Belmar of Canada was the leader after the short program. Now her marks, technical merit in the 5.0 to 5.4 range. A 20-year-old. Won a silver medal last year at Canadian Nationals, a bronze medal this season. Presentation marks 5.1 to 5.5. So Annie Belmar drops to second behind Angela Nikodinov of the U.S., who now has the lead.
And she should be very happy with that.
And here's the three-time and reigning Canadian national champion, Jennifer Robinson, who will be going to Nice, France to skate at the World Championships. Right now, she is in sixth place heading into this free skate.
Well, Jennifer is a very gentle and very lovely skater, and she's really very pretty to watch. She hits some beautiful lines. She's skating to Papa, Can You Hear Me? From Yentl. A nice opening, triple salchow.
Triple Lutz. Very interesting entrance to that. She swung from an outside to an inside to a back outside edge. That kind of makes it extra hard to pull off a triple Lutz after you do that.
Is her triple flip. She says this jump makes her very nervous. Two-footed that.
But I think she'd be happy to take it that way. Mm-hmm. again on this second triple Lutz. Watch the entrance here, the outside edge. Now watch, she's on an outside edge, swings to an inside edge, and goes back to an outside edge. So it's not a Flutz, but it, boy, it's hard one to pull off when you do that changing edge position. She's a very sophisticated skater. Long, elegant line.
It's a very nice program that was choreographed by Lori Nickel, choreographs for Michelle Kwan.
Not good to two-foot those, particularly when you're two-footing them right in front of the judges' stand. Triple toe loop.
Jennifer skating with some tendonitis and bursitis in her left ankle. It seems like every skater you talk to these days has some sort of injury at whatever event you happen to be at.
Injuries usually come from incorrect technique.
Do you think the schedules nowadays have something to do with it too?
I think it's incorrect technique.
More than that?
I think it's a combination of both of those things. Quite a schedule that the athletes do have to keep up with.
But more times than not, you see them missing jumps left and right, and there's a reason for that besides being tired. Pretty skater.
The 23-year-old from Windsor, Ontario, and some of the skaters in the crowd.
From her country.
Yes, from Canada, watching here, and a nice applause for Jennifer Robinson of Canada. Eighteenth at the World Championships last season. Jennifer will be back there. Here's the first set of marks for her for technical merit. Remember, she was in sixth after the short program. Along with Michelle and Doug Lee. Doug Lee, the former coach of Elvis Stoiko, of course, in the building here watching as well. 5.0 to 5.7 for Jennifer Robinson, and right now she is in fourth place overall. And here is Stacy Pengen, the 17-year-old from Fairport, New York. What a way to go into your first senior international competition, at least into the free skate, in third place with a chance to win the gold medal.
And if you look closely, she looks a lot like a young Peggy Fleming.
Well, thank you. I take that as a compliment.
It was intended to be.
Are there any Dick Buttons out there skating today?
Not today.
They're coming later, Terry. She's opening with a triple Lutz, double toe.
Oh, good, good.
I couldn't have done that better myself. A triple flip, double toe.
Wow. Did you see that switch again in the air?
Yes.
From where we were sitting, you could see a straight line curving in and then out again. Thank heaven she landed that.
Mm-hmm.
single.
Now triple Salchow.
Oh, whoa. She slipped off that back inside edge, and of course it doubled it.
Angela Nikodinov in the lead right now, and Stacy trains right alongside Angela in Detroit. They're both coached by Richard Callahan.
Triple toe loop combination. Double toe loop. Combination spin, first camel spin, catch foot position, nice catch. Layback, could have been better. The back could be stretched a little here, but a nice, nice combination overall. Circle on that, but lands it like with beautiful ease.
I'm surprised she gets so much lift. She doesn't reach back for that takeoff very much, but she's very effective. She has nice flow over the ice. I wish she would use moves like that, that slide spiral, to more of an advantage and use it to the beat of the music and hold it more.
It's like
much
she's
more effective.
It's like she's rushing through one move after the other without fully feeling it.
But that comes with time, with a better package, a better program, better choreography, better music. That package gets put together and it really shows you off to the best advantage.
But a very nice overall program for this young lady. She should be very proud of herself. It was a good presentation, a solid presentation, with all the elements steadily in place.
She finished sixth at the recent U.S. Championships. Stacy Penjin or Angela Nikodinov? We'll find out. The two Americans going for the gold.
And this was her opening triple Lutz double toe combination that was very solid. Went up in the air, very straight in the air, leaning over a little bit on the landing, up into the double toe. But it was a wonderful opening.
The technical merit marks for Stacy now in the 5.3 to 5.5 range.
And those are very creditable marks. It was a very creditable performance all the way around. She's like a lanky young filly, you know, just waiting for her to pull those edges together in the position. And I think she'll be a major position in American skating.
Presentation marks now 5.1 to 5.7. So Stacy right behind Angela Nikodinov, who still has the lead, but the two Americans occupy the two top spots. And up next, 19-year-old Fumi Suguri in fourth place and skating on home ice when we come back to Osaka. So here's the final skater in the ladies' free skate, Fumi Suguri on home ice. Fumi from Japan. She is in fourth place after the short program. She is the bronze medalist this season at the Japanese National Championships.
And she is coached by Nabu Sato, Yuka Sato's father. And Yuka Sato was the world champion in 1994.
Fumi still fighting for a spot on the Japanese world championship team with this performance.
Now look at how she sort of pumps on this stroking as she goes into this triple Lutz combination. Oh, way leaning back, so it didn't become a combination.
And it didn't become a triple lutz either.
Two problems.
Now a triple toe, double toe combination. Much better.
Very secure jumps in practice. I saw her do some wonderful triple flips, which is what she's doing right here. Let's see if it also works. Not quite.
Fumi's been dealing with injuries throughout her season as well. She injured both ligaments of both of her feet. Doctors actually wanted to perform surgery, and she said, no, I want to keep skating and just get therapy on those. Trains in Yokohama, which is near Tokyo.
Now a triple salchow. Inside edge takeoff. Oh. Didn't get the lift. Didn't complete the rotation.
Combination spin. Nicely centered, but each of the positions just not good enough. The back could be straighter, the leg straighter. Sort of slid off that edge, too.
And now a triple lutz.
Beautiful.
Very light.
She carries it so close to the board, you'd think that it would make her nervous. But that was a beautiful jump.
Nice footwork section there.
And look at the speed she has at this part of her program.
Final jump, double axel, double toe.
Good lift.
Very pleasant skater to watch.
Well, she's had to deal with the pressure of trying to make the Japanese world team in what can be a stressful situation, skating in front of a home crowd. Fumi Suguri.
And this was her very successful jump combination, the triple toe, double toe combination, nice and straight in the air, and a nice flowing edge in between the jumps. Very nicely done.
So it's Nikodinov over Penjin at the top. Let's see what happens with Fumi Suguri, who was in fourth heading into the free skate. 4.9 to 5.4 technical merit marks.
Very creditable marks. Getting nice speed.
And now, Dick, for presentation, 5.1 up to 5.4.
Again, creditable marks.
So that leaves her in fourth place in the final standings with Angela Nikodinov on top. She wins the gold medal here. A somewhat disappointing U.S. Nationals for her. She finished fourth. Last year, she won the bronze medal, but a big win here in Japan. Nikodinov edging out Stacy Penjin of the U.S., then Annie Belmar, who had the lead after the short program. quite an event for Angela Nikodinov. She has to wait to find out whether or not she will skate at the World Championships in Nice, but she knows she's the gold medalist here in Osaka. And Stacey Penjin, the 17-year-old, her first senior international competition, and she skates away with the silver medal. When we come back, the ice dancers will be out there on the ice, and the Americans are skating well there as well. Naomi Lang, Peter Chernyshev, the U.S. champs, they're in the lead here in Osaka.